Hello everyone, and thanks for taking some time out of your day to visit my channel. Now, one of my favorite discoveries from this reaction journey I've been on is the band Jinjer. I've absolutely adored every song I've done so far. All four of them are out of this world good. If you've watched my previous reactions, you've heard me blabber on about them, so I'm not gonna do it now. I'm gonna save it for later on, because I'm sure I'm gonna be blabbering again. So, I have a long list of suggestions. I love the comments on all the Jinjer reactions I do. Their fan base is incredible. I'm not saying that to suck up, it just, I do really enjoy the passionate comments. So many of your recommendations have piqued my interest. So I've decided to do a double reaction today. We're gonna be doing Who Is Gonna Be The One live. Second song I'm gonna do is Sit, Stay, Roll Over. Now I have quite a few suggestions, some people saying to do the official video, some say different live versions. I'm just gonna do the official one for now, but I may come back and do the live ones, we'll see how that goes. Anyway, let's not waste any more time, let's get started with Who Is Gonna Be The One. I'm always just so impressed with their songwriting ability and the way they develop riffs and themes, because so often they'll start something and like part of me is like, ah, is this gonna be the song that like I'm not as crazy about? Like how, where are they gonna take this? And I find myself, like forgive me, but I almost found myself doubting, because like their riff will have a certain complexity to it. And because I know as a guitarist, I can't make it work. I sometimes like doubt them, and then every time, they just kick my ass and prove me wrong and just do some amazing stuff. And the way they thicken up the sound is so unique. And oh, just so many times it's just beyond me how they do it. And just the way they build suspense and energy is just so clever. And it surprises me every time. And it's just without fail. And oh man, Tatiana, she just, her voice is incredible. The way she puts emphasis on certain lines is so impressive. And just she makes that voice look almost like it's easy. I cannot even fathom how she gets that sound. Again, all four of them just incredible. Okay, I'm gonna shut up and keep this going.
Doesn't wanna die, time. Lost, gonna be the one who got.
My goodness. You know what's crazy about them? It's like they're constantly f***ing with you. It's like, they're almost like they're trolling you. Like I was saying, it's so hard to predict where they're going with songs. And I love that. Each song I listen to, I can't predict. It's never following a basic formula. It's always so inventive and so original, and they've almost got a cheeky smile on their face, like you don't know what's coming next. Yeah, that bit at the end was almost reggae, and that sounds so different, and they all just do, just, oh man, it's really difficult to describe, because all four of them are just constantly mixing things up. The drummer is doing crazy rhythms, every song with the bassist has done some tapping and some awesome technique, the guitarist will be playing some hardcore, like drop B, I think, extremely heavy stuff, and then I'll just be playing some clean jazz chords and some reggae, and then that doesn't even mention Tatiana going in and out of the demon and angel mode, which I could just watch her do that all day. It's so interesting, like she did so much screaming at the start, I forgot that she had a great melodic voice too, so when that suddenly came out I was like shocked. They're just amazing, and they just keep you off your toes so much. It's so refreshing being able to listen to a band, listen to a new song, knowing that you just have no idea what to expect. It's really, really awesome. Okay, so I've been told the next one is, I mean, I assume it's pretty damn heavy. Some people were like, you're probably not even ready for this. So we're just gonna get straight into it, and it's, I should prepare myself for another ass whipping, I guess. But yeah, let's do it. Jinjer, sit, stay, roll over. There's not a good time to pause, and I almost forgot because I was so enthralled in that. Wow. You guys were not kidding. I'm actually so sweaty now. That was such an intense intro. I loved it. They've got such a great sound. That blast beat and the guitar and the bass are produced so perfectly. And then when Tatiana goes into full beast mode and does like a long scream that comes from like the bottom of her soul, you can just feel it. You can't help but get so fired up and just get goosebumps from it. This is so energetic and insane. Not much more I can say. I'm just gonna keep this going. Actually exhausted from doing two Jinjer songs in a row. I am spent because I don't know how these guys do it live. I mean, not just the energy, but the complexity. Like, it feels like so much time has gone into the songs. Just the amount of details and rhythmic changes that I cannot even process fast enough to really articulate properly. I feel like I need to listen to their song multiple times before I actually figure out each little bit that they've done. So to compose that is one thing, to memorize that is another thing, and then to perform it live, I can only imagine. Oh, as soon as I was hearing some of them riffs, I could not help but imagine myself in a mosh pit. Like, if I wasn't doing this video, I would have been jumping around going nuts. I wanted to like flip some furniture over and go crazy in that moment. Just unreal, the energy that they can evoke and pull out of you. It's unreal. I mean, goodness gracious. Don't ever f*** with Tatiana. She will destroy you. She's a terrifying human being when she gets into that demon mode. But holy crap, is it perfect for this music, doesn't it? Oh, and it's just amazing. The presence they all have is so impressive. I'm not sure, is it a different drummer they have for this one? I don't know if his hair rotated kind of like mine did, or if that's someone else. Maybe one of you told me this already, but I noticed that. But this guy was brilliant as well. He was really giving it with some of those blast beats. I couldn't believe the energy for that. And again, you just don't know where it's gonna go. You think you've got them sussed out, and then they'll just throw so many things at you in the course of a song that you're just on the edge of your seat. And oh, it's like a shot of adrenaline. It's so intense, so impressed. I know some of you are probably gonna be annoyed that I didn't do a live version of this, because I also wanna see this live now, but I do need a breather. I am actually exhausted. So yeah, I'm going to probably revisit them I'm definitely going to revisit Jinjer, but I would like to see a live version of this. I think some people said there was a live version from Melbourne, another one from Kiev. Let me know which one you kind of should check out, because I want to see them pull that off live for sure. But yes, two more absolute bangers once again. I never fail to be impressed and blown away by this band. Again, all I can do is blabber and just be nothing but impressed, because I don't know where they begin to compose these. I don't know how their brains work to make this work so well. It's just beyond impressive. But yeah, thank you for the suggestion, guys. I hope you enjoyed these double reaction today. Please keep the suggestions coming. Let me know if there's anything I missed, anything you want to share. Always happy to hear from you. If you want to support this channel, please be sure to hit the like button and the subscribe button. It does help me out very much, so I'd appreciate that. And yeah, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.